In today's video, we're going to work some problems about molality, freezing point depression, and first law of thermodynamics, which is calculating the heat, work, and the change in internal energy. Molality is one of the ways to express the concentration of a solution. The equation for molality is moles of solute divided by the mass of solvent in kilograms. There are some cases that the moles of solute or the mass of solvent is not given, so we sometimes need to use additional formula to get what we need. Here's an example. Calculate the molality of a solution containing 16.5 grams of magnesium chloride in 0.54 kilograms of water. So the given are the mass of solute, which is 16.5 grams, and the mass of solvent, which is 0.54 kilograms. So in order to calculate the molality, we need to get the value of mole first. So in order to get that, we will derive the formula of molar mass to get the value of mole. So mole is equal to mass over molar mass. So mole is equal to mass of solute, which is 16.5 grams divided by the molar mass of the magnesium chloride. Molar mass can be calculated through adding the atomic weight of the constituents atoms. So the atomic weight of magnesium is 24.31 plus the atomic weight of chlorine, which is 35.45 multiplied by 2 since it has 2 atoms. So the result is 0.17 mole. So since we got the value of mole, we can now calculate the molality of the solution. So molality is equal to mole of solute, which is 0.17 mole, divided by the mass of solvent, which is 0.54 kilograms, is equal to 0.31. So therefore, the molality of the solution is 0.31. So let's proceed to the next topic, which is freezing point depression. Freezing point depression is the decrease of the freezing point of a solvent on the addition of a solute. So the equation for freezing point depression is delta T is equal to negative I multiplied to K sub F multiplied to M. Delta T is the freezing point of solution minus the freezing point of the solvent. I is the Van't Hoff factor, and it represents how many particles the solute breaks up into solvent. For non-electrolytes, I is equal to 1. K sub F is the molar freezing point depression constant, and it measures the lowering of the freezing point of a solution for one molality solution of solute particle, where M is the molality. So here's an example. Calculate the freezing point of a solution of 5 grams of diphenyl dissolved in 200 grams of benzene. So the given are the mass of diphenyl, which is 5 grams, the mass of benzene, which is 200 grams, the freezing point of benzene, which is 5.5 degrees Celsius, and the value of K sub F, which is 5.12 degrees Celsius per molality. First, we need to find the moles using the molar mass formula. So mole is equal to mass over molar mass. So 5 grams divided by the atomic weight of carbon, which is 12.01 multiplied to 12, plus the atomic weight of hydrogen, which is 1.01 multiplied to 10. So it is equal to 5 grams divided by 154.22 grams per mole. So the result is 0.03 mole. So after that, we convert the mass of benzene into kilograms. So 200 grams is equal to 0.2 kilograms. So we can now calculate the molality. So molality is equal to 0.03 mole divided by 0.2 kilograms, which is 1.5 m. So delta T, which is the freezing point of solution minus the freezing point of benzene, which is 5.5 degrees Celsius, is equal to negative I, which is 1, multiplied to K sub F, which is 5.12 degrees Celsius per molality, multiplied to the molality, which is 1.5 m, is equal to negative 7.68 degrees Celsius. So freezing point of solution minus 5.5 degrees Celsius is equal to negative 7.68 degrees Celsius. So the freezing point of the solution is equal to 5.5 degrees Celsius minus 7.68 degrees Celsius. So the result is negative 2.18 degrees Celsius. Therefore, the freezing point of solution is equal to negative 2.18 degrees Celsius. The first law of thermodynamics is about calculating work and heat that is being released or absorbed by the system and its change in internal energy. So the equation for the change in internal energy is delta U is equal to Q plus W, where delta U is the change in internal energy, Q is the heat, and W is the work. The equation for getting the work is negative P multiplied to delta V, where P is the pressure and delta V is the change in volume. And the equation for getting the heat is C multiplied to delta T, where C is the heat capacity and delta T is the change in temperature. So here's an example. A gas expands against a constant external pressure of 2 atm from 5 liters to 10 liters, and at the same time it absorbs 400 joules of heat from its surrounding. Calculate the work and the change in internal energy. The given data are the heat, which is 400 joules, the initial volume, which is 5 liters, the final volume, which is 10 liters, and the pressure, which is 2 atm. In order to get the change in internal energy, we should calculate the work first. So work is equal to negative P multiplied to delta V. So delta V is equal to final volume minus the initial volume. It is 10 liters minus 5 liters. So the delta V is 5 liters. So negative P, which is 2 atm multiplied to 5 liters, is equal to negative 10 latm. So we need to convert the latm to joules. So for every 1 latm, it is equivalent to 101.3 joules. So negative 10 latm is equivalent to negative 1013 joules. Since it has negative sign, the work is done by the system. Since we got the value of the work, we can now get the change in internal energy. So delta U is equal to Q plus W, where Q is 400 joules plus the work, which is negative 1013 joules. So the result is negative 613 joules. So since it has also a negative sign in it, the internal energy is done by the system. That's all, and thank you.